Hi, everybody. Welcome to my Success is Easy podcast. And today I'm very excited to introduce to you a new friend and a fabulous guest to have on my show. So welcome to Success is Easy podcast. And this episode is Mastery Under Pressure with my special guest, Tina Greenbaum. Thanks for being here, Tina. I'm so glad we met.
Thank you so much.
She's super talented, and I loved her name, Mastery Under Pressure. Oh my gosh, what a cool thing, right? Because that's what we're going through right now with all the stuff that's going on in our world, how to master our emotions, master everything that's going on, and making success still flow to us. So let me tell you a little bit about Tina. Tina works with those who want to increase their performance level in high stakes, high pressure situations like we're going through right now. She is an optimal performance specialist. Didn't even know there was such a thing. That's very cool. I love it. And her signature program, Mastery Under Pressure, will empower you to use neuroscience, which I love, energy psychology, and the current learning theories that she has to offer. In addition, her Mastery Under Pressure program that she offers, Tina's expertise is in guiding others through their psychology and personal issues, helping them cope with the demands that personal struggles place on them as they strive to create success and then allow it to come easily to them because they have all so much pressure that they're putting the brakes on, and she's allowing that to happen with this mastery she does. And she likes to say the only thing standing between you and your goals, what could that be, Tina?
Is you.
Yes. We get in our own way a lot, right? Oh gosh, it's not so
many times without even realizing it.
Yeah. And so, you know, you got into this business. Let's just start with that. It's like why you got into this business to help people with, you know, mastering when they're really hard, having a hard time to cope with things.
So I am by training a psychotherapist. I'm a licensed clinical social worker. So I started out as a clinical social worker working with very difficult populations, women with eating disorders and addictions and anything that you could think of, anxiety, depression, alcoholism, all wrapped up. So I had a really, really good training. And what I found very early on, was that people could tell me about their mother, their father, their sister, their brother, but they had no skill. Like, got a little tickle.
So they had bubbling up, right? Some good energy, some good ideas are bubbling up.
Yes. So what I realized was if they wanted to, they could tell them, they had a lot of insight, but when it came to going for a job, you know, feeling good about themselves, putting them forward, looking forward to their careers, really they had no skill. So I also have a big background in sports psychology. My father was a great athlete. I love sports. My kids were, one of my kids in particular was an elite athlete. He went all the way up to the national levels in soccer. And I used to say, I don't know a lot about soccer, but I know a lot about psychology. And sports psychology is actually Eastern thought. So focus, relaxation, dealing with negative self-talk, you know, visualization, dealing with fear. Those are all the things that I teach, but they come from, if you were a great athlete, you would no sooner go out there to compete without training the mental side.
Definitely.
And yet, we put people into high pressured, high stakes environments with no training. And so I like to say that good mental health is not a natural sport, it's a learned sport. And these are skills, just like all the other skills that people spend thousands and thousands of hours and dollars and learning, but it all starts with what goes on between you and you.
Right. And you know, there's these like these seminar junkies, you know, I've been putting on seminars for 15 years, but I'm no junkie. I'm implementing, but I see people come back over and over and over again. Those people are like, why are you showing up? I call them out when they come to my event. So if they come to my event, like, you know, the third time for sure, sometimes the second time, third time I show up at my event and they haven't done anything. I'm like, why do you keep showing up? You're not doing anything. They're just like, you know, just taking space because, you know, if you're just sitting here just thinking you're going to learn, this is going to rub off on you. It's not going to happen. There's something still stuck. Like they say, I want this. I want success to come to me, but they keep blocking it. And I'm sure you see that.
You bring up a really good point because a lot of times people do want it, but they don't know how to get beyond it. Mm. I say a lot of times what I teach is common knowledge, but not common practice. And if you don't know why you're not moving forward, then that's the time to get help, rather than spending, you know, again, a fortune on things that are not bringing you results. What I love about my work, and maybe probably you do too, I like to get the root problem. Like, why are you not moving forward? Not
right.
Judging you, not being mad at you, not, you know, it's like the how come. And if you don't know the answer because you don't have really good access to your own unconscious material, which is where everything is laid down and everything operates from, is from the unconscious. And we spend in our Western culture all our time up. I always say, what do you do? And people ask me, I teach people how to get below the neck, because there is a universe in the body that gives us information. So between, I've come from a body-mind experience, and these two things have to be able to communicate with one another. Otherwise, we're only working with half a deck.
Right, and a lot of times people just can't figure it out. They cannot figure it out on their own. That's why they need you. So then they haven't worked on the mastery thing. They just keep stuck. So a gentleman came to my event. It was at least the third time he came to my event. And he came up to me and he said, Deb, I've been to your highly paid expert workshop 3 times now, and I've been surrounded by all of these masters, you know, the high level speakers. I've studied you, I've studied them, and why can't I move? I've wanted to be a speaker for over 20 years, and why can't I do it? I said, I don't have the answer to that, but you have the answer to that. It's right there in your head. And I pointed to his head, and he goes, oh, that's so brilliant. No one's ever told me that. I'm thinking, what the hell? But again, it isn't just a head. You had to go deeper, obviously. And
right. And if we don't know the path, because we haven't been taught. That's not our culture. We don't think that way. Our parents didn't learn this stuff. You know, my parents were wonderful parents, but they didn't, you know, they didn't know the depth of the ways that we could get to things that I have learned, you know, through my education. Training.
Right. And so we feel just get stuck. And then you think all those opportunities, it's so easy. See, here it was success just surrounding him. It's so much easier to be successful than it is to fail. And here it is, success just surrounding him. He's like, it's all there. He saw it. It's all there. And why can't I tap into this? And it had
One of the other things that I'd love to say in terms of the audience that we're talking to, which is one of a small business owner, which is what I've been for the last 30 some years. And just like being a business owner, you have your area of expertise. So my area is in you know, the counseling and the psychology piece. And then I also have to be a business owner. And there's a lot of things that I may not know as a business owner. And so thinking that I could do it all by myself is a myth. And surrounding yourself with really good people who can do the things that you don't do, or even point out the things that you're not doing, is so critical.
Most
for
definitely.
A business to be successful.
So you mentioned that too, small business owners. So what do you think is some of the biggest mistakes small business owners make when they come to like almost self-sabotaging themselves? So I believe people get to a certain level and then they tap out. Like, you can only make so much money or have so much success.
So Harv Eker, which I took so many years ago, Secrets of the Millionaire Mind, you know, he says, your money mindset is your mindset. So if you have an idea that this is as much as you're going to make, even unconsciously, you are going to prove that. You're going to actually do that. Mm. So in order to, and this is something that I had to work on at some point as well, I got to a certain level and really frustrated that I wasn't moving forward. And so number one, I had to be brutally honest with myself.
Yep.
Like, what's going on? Why am I not further along, given how hard I work and how good I think I am at what I do. And I'm still not reaching those levels that I want. So I had to start to look around and ask, and you know, what's going on, different places that I would go, and I would study, and I would study other people. I'd study myself. And then what I realized is that I needed to surround myself with people that could appreciate what I do and also work at the level that I do. So I love big minds. I like really smart people, really creative people, because I love challenges. And so I made a commitment that I needed to up-level myself. I needed to, you know, I've been doing this now, it's coming on 37 years, just about 37 years. And then I just started to look around and I looked at other people who were highly successful. How many years have you been doing what you do, and how much do you know? And you couldn't possibly know what I know about my business, because it's not your business. Right. So I just had to really own, I know a lot. I'm really good at this. And I had to act as if I was really the expert that I am. So again, it comes back to the mindset of, like, I really called it up-leveling myself. So that when I would meet somebody and I would talk to them, no matter who it was, you know, I'd reach my hand out and say, hi, how are you? Was it, you know, just even the body language, you know, just getting tall and straight and feeling really good about me and just remembering, my goodness, how many hours I have put into this, how many thousands of dollars in training, and come to that meeting or to that person with that psyche, you know, with that mindset. Yeah, I can help you.
Yeah, definitely. So a couple of points you pointed out there, you know, the money mindset thing, and then also getting yourself ready for that. So, you know, many years ago, I went to T. Harv Eker's event and shifted me too. I was making a lot of money and I was going through it. I was like, you know, almost getting rid of it because I didn't feel worthy because it was coming fast. I had to learn that. I didn't learn that from growing up. And I learned bad habits about money, you know, and throwing money away like my dad did, and throwing, you know, kind of gambling on businesses and stuff like that. So there's a level of risk you take, and there's a level of, you know, going slower to get it to the right level. But when you, a couple of things you also said about, you know, you're kind of tapping into that confidence level, how you present yourself and up level. So people have to get to a point where they're saying to themselves, I'm worthy enough to tap into my confidence and up level to bigger mindsets. And so
this is a really important thing. Okay. Because when we use affirmations, this is kind of my personal opinion. And we say, I'm really worthy. I'm really good. But there's another part of it that says, you got to be kidding.
You know,
you're
right.
Not really, you know. So that's where the sabotage comes in. So we have to have our whole body, mind has to be in alignment and agreement that this is the truth. And so when I get into that posture, I feel it. I feel it in my gut. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so as people are starting to look at this and think about this, it's like, do you really believe it? And if you don't believe it, why don't you believe it? Just the way that you just used your example. Well, I'm not even worthy of having all this money. If you don't know that and you're not conscious of it, you will continue to do the same thing over and over and over and over and over again.
Like a broken record, you know, and it's like why can't I get, and then they get all frustrated. Well, I can't get ahead. I can't do this. And yeah, because you've done it. It's so powerful. The mind, and what you teach here is the, you know, the mastering it. So give us an example of somebody that you saw like tap in and really change from your tutelage of this, you know, they've mastered it.
So one of my favorite stories is a client who is French, and she was raised in a very proper French home. Her father was a restaurateur. He owned a restaurant, and she worked in the restaurant for many years. So she had a lot of knowledge. And she came to New York, which is where I was living at the time, and she became a manager of a pretty upscale restaurant. And so what she found was she was great with her employees. You know, she was great at building teams and getting a lot of agreement, but she would walk into the kitchen where this crazy chef was, and as soon as he started to kind of be very condescending, she would shrink. She would just fall apart. And so that was sort of her presenting, quote, her presenting thing that she came and we started to work on. And by the time we finished, she's still a client now, then went on to 5-star restaurants and big hotels. And now we just do executive coaching. And but she really kind of used that chef as the example, because he was very much like her dad, who was a, you know, kind of very strong. And when we think of the arrogant French, he was at the top of the list. But she learned how to manage him. She learned how to have enough confidence within herself that she could see him as an equal. And that's the whole thing, that we have to kind of really, you know, it's really wonderful to put people on pedestals and appreciate and admire them, but it doesn't mean that they're better than us. Mm-hmm. And so she really kind of worked with that piece and really owned her intelligence and her power and things that that chef could never do. Right. And then she started to really teach him how to work with other people.
Oh, I love it. You know, and she was actually dealing with her father at the same time, because I believe that even women, you know, will, and men both too, you know, find their relationships of what we know. Sometimes they're bad for us and we just keep following that pattern till we figure it out. You know, that happens in relationships, it happens in business, happens the same way. And so it's like, you know, you, another point you just picked up on, and I want to touch on, is that some people feel like, you're at this level and I don't know that when, if I reach out to you, you'll even respond to me because you're so busy and you're so successful. Or if I approach you, you know, it's intimidating. And I've heard this myself. You know, people come to me, I'm like, I'm just me. Like, you know, I'm this girl from Gary, Indiana. What are you talking about? You know, we're sitting in the same room. What, why wouldn't you come and talk to me? And so the thing is that, you know, why people, how do they get beyond that? Because when you said that leveling is huge, nobody is beyond you and nobody is at a certain thing, because underneath we're all little scared kids at times, right? We all have our insecurities, but some of us have just mastered and worked on it a little bit more. We don't show it, you know, because for the majority of time we got our act together.
It's true. But, and that's the piece about people and really understanding that. I two things that you say. One is people like to talk about themselves. So when you ask somebody who you think is untouchable, the truth is if they're the kind of person that you really admire, they're going to be a person that is humble. Not everybody's that way. Okay. And if somebody doesn't have time and they're snotty and they, well, then they may not be the person for you.
Right.
But for the most part, people like helping other people. And if we just kind of flip it around a little bit, and if somebody came and asked you about what you were doing, my guess is that they would be very gracious. So I had somebody very recently who found me online, and I have, which I'm going to offer at the end of this, a quiz that people can take. And so she took my quiz online, and if you have an interest in actually moving forward, then you can make an appointment with me. So she makes an appointment, and I made this appointment with her. It was a 30-minute complimentary consultation. And I knew from, she was in Denmark, or the Netherlands. Mm. And I knew that she really didn't have the money to pay me, you know, my regular fee, but I had a small program that I could sell her, and I sold her for next to nothing. And she was like, oh my God, you're so famous. You know, I can't believe that you're doing it. I mean, like, I was so touched that she actually reached out to me.
Right.
And I was so pleased and happy that I had something that I could give her. And so in answer to your question, go for it.
Right. Well, you know, you're, it's because you're, you know, people don't realize that very successful people are willing to help people more than the average person. The average person who is struggling, that holds back, like, I can't share any secrets because my competition will get it. Or, you know, if I tell them my secrets, they'll go and move ahead of me. Those are insecure people that are not successful. Successful people have already done it. They've had people that have helped them. They're more likely to help you. People at higher levels are more likely to help you than people at lower levels. And people don't get that because it's just a success. Success is a cycle. And when you have success, you have to share it. And people that, anybody has a high level of success has had people share it with them. And that's what most people just don't get, that they're more likely. And it's how you ask, because there's a whole chapter in my book of how you ask people, you know, to help you. And again, she just shared her story. You felt compelled. I want to help her. And that's what success allows you to do. But, you know, don't you feel that too, that, you know, that most successful people are willing to give a lot more?
Absolutely. Absolutely. When I think about the people in my circle now that I have reached out to and made created relationships with, I'll tell you another story. There's somebody in our group from C-Suite where somebody had, I had been working with this person, you know, hoping that he would hire me and he kept putting me off, but kept calling back and whatever. And so finally, like right before I was getting ready to go on vacation, I was going to, on New Year's, we were going to Thailand. And so the night before, I get a call back from this guy, send me a proposal. So it was at 8 o'clock at night, and I texted one of our friends, you know, one of my colleagues, and I said, I need help. I really want this proposal to be really very professional. And he comes from a big corporate thing. He sat with me for well over an hour, hour and a half, helped me write the whole proposal. Wow. I sent it out and there it was. And it was like, it was such a gift to me that, and I felt really good about the way it looked and, you know, and the whole thing. Had I not reached out, I would have sent him something perhaps as a small business owner, as opposed to a more professional corporate, you know, kind of thing.
Did you get the deal?
It's still pending. Now this all happened with coronavirus.
Okay. So, it's going to come. It's all going to come. It's a little bump. Yeah. It's a little pause. That's all it is. Awesome.
And at the same time though, but what's really important is I have reached out to him several times and just said, I'm here. Complimentary. If you need anything, please get in touch. He hasn't, but that's okay.
Right.
You know, and it's making and yourself visible.
Well, and I think the confidence of knowing, like reaching out, knowing the confidence of knowing that you're going to have success, that you're going to get clients versus being pushy. Because when you're not feeling successful or you're not feeling confident, and then you're pushing, you know, and that's what a lot of people do. They'll push. And that push will push people away versus bring success and money to them. And that's probably another part of the mindset mastery that you teach as well.
Absolutely. It's based on many years ago, I had a healer who said to me, Tina, you have to work spiritually. And I didn't really have the faintest idea what he meant at the time. And I found a book as I was kind of walking down the street one time, and the book says, you can have it all. By this guy, Arnold Patton. This is maybe 20, 25 years ago already. And I read the book, I opened up the book, and he talked about universal principles. There are certain things that are just part of the universe. And, you know, the sun sets, rises in the east and sets in the west, the rivers run downstream. And there's certain things that if we follow the flow of the way the universe works, life works. And if we don't, it doesn't. We keep bucking up against ourselves and that resistance that we push up. And when you see martial arts and, you know, you see somebody pushing and then somebody moves away. And so it's really understanding at a very, very big level how the universe works. And that's when you talk about success is easy. It's because you're following certain principles.
Most definitely.
Of how life works, giving and receiving. So what we were just talking about is people, in order to receive, you have to be able to give. And in order to give, you have to be able to receive, because it's a cycle.
Right. And there's certain laws you mentioned. I mentioned that in the book too. The law of attraction is one thing, but it's not enough to make it work. You also need the universal law of action. And that's the piece. It's like, okay, you can't just sit there. Okay, fine. It came. What am I doing now? You got to take action for it to flow to
that's
you
right.
as well.
And the other piece of that is, you know, the other piece that I put in, it's the action, but it's also alignment. You know, that every part of you, and I keep going like this all the time, I'm going to kind of like this straight line from head to toe, that every part of me agrees that this is something worth going for, because we need that energy. You know, whatever you focus on expands. So if you focus on the negative energy, okay, that's what's going to expand. And if you focus on something, again, I call it productive thinking. Do my thoughts produce something useful? It's not just positive thinking. You know, if I believe that I can do this and I believe it down in my toes and I talk to myself that, come on, you can do this, but not like you could do this. You can do it. I mean, the energy piece is so incredibly important that we feel it, not just the words.
And I know that my listeners need what you have, because I didn't realize even that I needed it when I was already still successful in my business. And I started working with a personal development person that I respected, was my coach at the time, similar to a lot of things that you do, teaching that mastery. And learning that mastery, what you teach, was a dramatic shift for me in my life. Because when I was learning this, this gal came to me and she said, you know, you're not tapping in all the way. And I'm like, what do you mean I'm not tapping in all the way? I'm teaching business skills. You know, no, when you're speaking, you need to connect. You need to connect your head and your heart. I said, but that's what you do. It's a spiritual connection. But that doesn't work in business. She goes, no. You're going to see how the difference is that when you take your head and you connect it to your heart and put that out to the audience, how difference it's going to make. And so she taught me how to tap in. And then I would tap in a little bit and I would go, because I was still a little resistant, you know, thinking it. And then I tap in, I'm like, oh, this feels different. And I start tapping in more, tapping in more. It was about me becoming my true authentic self and being vulnerable and letting my heart speak with my head, even though I'm teaching business, and it shifted everything. So I get what you're talking about. And I get the value of what you offer, Tina.
And it doesn't come overnight. You say success is easy, but this is not necessarily easy. We have to be willing to face ourselves. Just like you said, I tried this and then I waited and I saw the results. And then I tried it again, because what we're doing, bringing it into the neuroscience, we're building new neural pathways into actually the brain and the cells. And so that when a situation comes up, the old self, the one that kind of pulls back and withdraws, and she's still there, he's still there, but he's not activated. What's activated is this new learning, you know, and confidence, and this is a really important thing, confidence is built on little successes.
Most definitely.
Little successes.
And you had to test it. Like you put your foot in your toe in the water, you test it and you go, okay, that didn't kill me. That was okay. Felt kind of good actually. Then another little bit, but again, it's like working out. It's a muscle, or it's an exercise that you need to do to learn that new habit, your neural pathway. So you know, because you know neuroscience, so you've got it how it actually scientifically works within your brain.
Yeah, there's so much to learn, and I always feel like when people take the time to go to the depths of what it takes to know yourself intimately, just really, really intimately. It's a secret weapon.
Yes, it's a secret weapon. Love that. Secret weapon. Oh my gosh, it is. I mean, I don't know if you say that often or if that just came out, but that is so cool.
It came out, you know.
Oh, you got to use that more. I love it. You teach people how to use their secret weapon.
Yeah, it truly, it's, and I've been through a lot in my life, you know, a lot of, as many people have, and people who are successful don't ever think it's a one way, you know, just like we start here and we get to the top and there's a straight line, because it's not. It, for most people, and most really successful people I know, have had major ups and downs and bankruptcies and, you know, picking themselves back up again. And so that resilience, some people are more naturally resilient than others. They see things in a certain way, but resiliency can be learned.
Mm-hmm, most definitely.
Most definitely. And practiced over and over and over again. So that I was on a podcast yesterday, and this is what happens over time. And I'm sure you can appreciate this, Debbie, for the amount of work that you've done yourself. I feel like I'm like this fine tuned instrument. You know, I pick up everything. You know, I pick up people's nuances. I pick up tones of voice. And so over time, your intuition just gets stronger and stronger, and you learn how to depend on it a lot more, that you don't have to think so much. And is this, so there's just so many pieces and so many layers that it's a lifetime's worth of work. Honestly, it never stops. I love to keep learning. I love, you know, things that I don't know and hearing it from other people in different ways, but it's, I wouldn't give this up for anything.
No, it's your life's work. It's your thing. But, you know, people tell me all the time too, you're so intuitive in business. But again, it has been over time to nurture, to work on mastering myself along with business. That's why I wanted you to have on the show today, because I know how critical it is. We don't learn this in school, and you could spend thousands of dollars, like you said, learning skills. But if you don't change who you are, then you're not going to get to that next level and allow it to flow. And it's success. Success is easy, because when you are at that place, when you have done that work and you have intuitively tapped into what you do and love what you do, like we have that passion, success is easy. It's just like, hey, look for next opportunity. It's right around the corner. When you meet someone, like I met Tina, you know, intuitively, yeah, I want to reach out to her. I want to connect with her. I don't know what we're going to do. We just got on the phone. We said, hey, we're going to do, hey, and then it's like, you need to be on my podcast, right? It's like, I love what you're doing. We need to connect. I want you to share your message. So you don't have to figure it out. It just, but when you,
we don't have, we can't figure it out.
Yeah, right. It changes every day. We don't even know what's happening every day now.
Oh, especially. And I think that this is also bringing back the fun into being an entrepreneur. What I love about it, it's a world of possibility. I just do not know. I have no idea where this could take us, where that conversation could take me, where this person, where that. And then when it just starts to kind of flow, and people call me, you know, from that I've had my name for a year or 2 years sometimes, or I don't know, but it's just really kind of fun being in it, being in the game, and meeting really interesting people and exciting people that are doing cool stuff. And then, you know, if you need what I have, hey.
Yeah. But you put yourself in that space. You had to have mastered enough to say, I'm worthy to be in that space. At people at higher levels, it's a lot more fun game. They get it. They take action. They look for opportunities. They look for ways to share success. It's a much different place than people that are insecure and not ready for themselves. And a lot of people are in that situation. They're listening to the podcast today going, I don't have that circle of influence. Yeah, they're all around you. Find one. Find one. If it's not the right group for you, then join another one. You have to invest in yourself, because when you're at people at higher levels, like you said, you started with that, is that it brings you up and it makes you say, I want to master. And then you have to invest again. You have to invest with people like Tina to go, hey, I need a program with her. I need to work with her and work on some stuff, because it isn't like a skill you just learn and you get to go do something with that skill. It's a life skill you take with the entire rest of your life.
Raising children, you know, dealing with bosses, dealing with difficult people. I mean, we're just talking on one part about, you know, just kind of creating your business, but wherever you go, whatever you do in your life, you have this. Again, this secret weapon. You yes. have this. You know how. I can listen to a conversation, and in 2 seconds, I can tell you whether it's going to be a successful one, you know, or it's going to go south, or what exactly the people are doing, and then how to navigate that. I mean, how powerful is that?
Right. You know? I gotta go. Click. I'm glad we didn't hang up on me when I called you. Hey, thanks so much for being here today. I mean, it's awesome stuff. We can sit here and talk all the time, but we want them to follow you. So I know you have an invitation for the quiz. I took the quiz. I loved it. I think it's such a cool thing. So tell them about your Mastery Under Pressure quiz and how they can do that.
Okay, so it's www.masteryunderpressure.net. And that's a quiz. There's a couple questions on these five topics that I talk about: focus, relaxation, dealing with negative self-talk, how to visualize, and dealing with fear. And you'll get a score. And you'll also, if you're really interested and really interested in moving forward and having a conversation, I offer a 30-minute consultation. It's a complimentary consultation. And then we can talk from there. I have an online program that is awesome, that, you know, they say in AA, it works if you work it. This stuff works if you work it. And so
I love what you're doing. Yeah. So start with the quiz. It's masteryunderpressure.net, correct? Masteryunderpressure.net. Go take the quiz for free. It's really fun to take. Be totally honest with yourself, because we like to cheat when we're taking quizzes, but you can't cheat because you're only cheating yourself. Be honest so that you get instant feedback too. It's like you fill it out and it's like, bam, you get the feedback. You're like, oh, okay, wow, that's pretty cool. Then gosh, Tina, you're being so generous to for the people that the right people will get a call. Cause I always, you know, we value your time. And if you feel that you're serious, then shout for the call. Otherwise, you got it all figured out. You're not going to take the time to figure out to do the quiz anyways. So, you know, there are some things you're going to the quiz. There are some things you need to work on. Doesn't matter how old we are. We go through stuff in life. So awesome. Thanks again, Tina, for being here on my Success
Is Easy podcast. And then my website is just masteryunderpressure.com that you can just learn more.
And learn more about all the things that she's doing, masteryunderpressure.com. Check it out. And I'm sure she's got a lot of great stuff in there that that they're going to learn more about. So I'm so glad you're here, Tina. And thanks so much for sharing this. My pleasure. Love you. All right. Have a great day.
You too. Bye-bye now.
Bye.